As the United States and Florida continue to see a surge in COVID-19 cases, healthcare systems are overwhelmed and some businesses are still struggling. Dr. Richard Besser, the former acting director of the CDC, is stressing the importance of more data collection and more funding to keep everyone safe. Dr. Besser, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Why is stronger data collection a key component of an effective response to COVID-19 pandemic, the pandemic that's currently still ongoing?
Yeah, I mean, this is a really important issue. When you look at how the pandemic has hit communities so far, Black Americans, Latino Americans, Native Americans, people in lower income communities have been hit the hardest. And in order to really identify what's going on in your city, in your town, in your state, you need to be able to collect data down to the neighborhood, to the zip code, and break that down by race, by ethnicity, so that you know what's going on and you can address the needs of everyone in your population. You know, when you're just looking at the state level or at a city level, you may see some general trends, hopefully trends that will in the future be going down. But even in a place where you're seeing a reduction in overall cases, there may be parts of your community that are not getting the resources that they need in order to stay safe. And without that, you can see continued transmission throughout a city where things would otherwise be going very well.
And speaking of communities, how is public health the roadmap to a safe and equitable economic recovery? How is that possible?
Yeah, you know, I'm so concerned when I hear public health being put forward as the enemy of the economy. In order to get people back to work in a sustained way, in order for people to feel comfortable going out and shopping and going and into different businesses, they have to know that they're safe. We have to know that our workers who are going back have the protection so that they're safe. And that's what public health provides. It provides the tools, the advice, the recommendations, so that as people are carefully going back to work, as hopefully we're able to get children back to school, it's done in a way that keeps everyone safe. Without following the guidance of public health, you can get some people back to work quickly. You can get people into your bars and restaurants. And within a few weeks, you're going to see a big increase in cases.
And so you're saying leaders at all levels have to be at that table, having that dialogue on this matter.
It's so important. You know, what we're hearing now is one conversation from our leaders in public health, and it's about how important it is to follow these recommendations of wearing masks, keeping 6 feet away from others, washing hands, staying home if you're sick. And then some politicians with a very different message of this is overblown. Let's get out there and spend money and boost our economy. Let's get back to our social life. And that just doesn't work. We need a one way. We need an American way. You need a Florida way that is all in support of public health.
And you're saying we need to hear from these officials every day during this pandemic.
Yeah, we need to hear from our public health leaders. And you know what I like is public health leader out there front and center giving the message and a politician standing next to them nodding, showing that they agree, that they affirm the recommendations of public health. And you want to see your political leaders modeling the behavior that public health is recommending. So that means wearing masks, not shaking hands, not being in crowded places, showing what it means to move forward slowly and carefully so that the economic restart can be in a sustained way.
Dr. Besser, thank you so much for taking the time and speaking with us today. Thank you.
It's a real pleasure. Thank you.